All right, we're here for round two. My hand is excellent. I will keep. Finally, I've drawn Battle Screech. I've been waiting for so long. Ooh, Man of War. Wonderful draw. I hope my opponent casts Sarcomancy. That would make me so happy. I'm going to hold the island to conceal information. Also, there's like a 1% chance that he casts Choking Sands to destroy it. I guess there's also a possibility of him having him to Turok and making me discard it, which would be a disaster. Well, I will say I'm not thrilled to have Death's Head Buzzard be the spell that my opponent cast, because it's so good against my Battle Screech. But we'll see how this plays out. I wonder if there's anything in the format that lets you sack a creature. I can't think of anything, but you never know. Well, that was a bit of a bizarre play by my opponent. Cycling in his main phase instead of casting Death's Head Buzzard. I wonder if it's because he has the card Famine in his hand. There was one in the draft, and it would be good right now, so I'm not going to rule it out completely. Here, I'm just going to cast this Aven. It's not particularly good on this board, but it's a creature I can put in play that allows me to advance my board state and also not be too bad against Famine, which is what I think he has. Yeah. The reason I cast it is because these lands in my hand are almost completely useless. So I got to play the game in a natural way, but also not lose too much value there. Keen-Eye Aven or Skywing Aven? This is what I'm going to do. I'm going to go... I kind of want to go land Keen-Eye Aven. Keen-Eye Aven. So that I may top deck a land to cast Man of War and Skywing Aven. Seems like a pretty good play to me. The only downside to that is I'm casting a Keen-Eye Aven, which may end up being bad. And in which case I would want to cycle it, so I'm committing to a play that doesn't let me decide later to cycle it or not. Also, playing all these extra additional lands means my Skywing Aven will have less cards to discard to it, which stinks. Wow. Nightstalker. Ugh. Well, I just got owned pretty bad because Battle Screech would have been a fine card against that thing. Well, not going to be an easy one to win. Does it say target player? Target opponent. Okay, so he can't use Predatory Nightstalker on himself to destroy Death's Head Buzzard. It's worth knowing. Alright, I'm all in, boys. If he can destroy his own Death's Head Buzzard, I'm basically going to lose anyways. So, I guess I don't have to play this Aven. I'll just do this. And then I'll say go. In the future, I'll Mana War that Buzzard, put him to 5. Pretty good board state for me then. Or rather, I'll probably win. Gonna take it. Six mana. Ugh. You gotta be kidding me. That card is not remotely beatable. Well, literally cannot beat it. So if I bounce the buzzard, he blocks. Oh my goodness. Well, I'm just gonna attack with everything and hope it works. I really wish I had cast that Aven. last turn. The reason I didn't was I just wanted to play a bit more conservatively. If he could somehow kill the Buzzard, I could grind out a game with the Skywing even in my hand. But definitely not the best play against Visara, given that I just lose now, where I could have dealt 2 extra damage. I think my only out is to... don't even have another Man of War to hit. And Swords to Plowshares, good grief. Yeah, there was no way I was winning this game. That card's just not beatable. Ooh, that's a good draw. Still don't think I can win. I think I literally have, like, no outs. I guess I would barely win if I drew a 2-1 shadow for 2. My opponent's deck is very good against mine. Swords to Plowshares, Famine, Death's Head, Buzzard, Visara. Just really good sweepers, mass removal, regular removal. Yeah, I'm just so dead. This is like the least close game ever. Dark Hatchling, like... my opponent's deck is great. I really just want to concede because this is so brutal. Rather than like grind out this million turn game where I just like know that it's just over. Just for my sanity, I want to give up. Well, I'm definitely going to board in Counterspell and Shelter. Just because he has so much removal. Wish I had those deep analyses that I was passing around the table. Just because if I'm going to grind out a game, card advantage is a really solid way to do it. This card is so good. What did he do? Cruel Bargain. He paid half his life? I mean, that card is gas in his deck. And Mox Emerald. Oh, man. Well, my best out is that somehow he casts Famine and kills himself. Because it doesn't seem likely that I'll kill him through natural means. Or somehow I hit, like, runner cards that do things. Dead. I love Visara. It's such a cool card. Six, seven, eight, nine? What in the world costs 9 mana? Oh, it's a white X? I don't know what this is. Death Grasp. Well, fair enough. Yeah, that is fair enough. Should I board in Gilded Light against Death Grasp and... the Night Stalker? Seems like it's a snap no on that one. Boarding in Lonely Sandbar instead of Island, because if the game grinds to a, you know, long, interesting game, then it's a bit better. Shelter certainly is better than... Keen Eye Aven's pretty bad. Devout Witness. Yeah, I'll take that out. Just bad card. Karmic Guide is literally the best card ever against him. He probably just loses if I draw it, because it's pro black. I could see an argument for Astral Slide, but I only have seven cards with cycling. Could see an argument for Circular Logic, but just not that many cards go into my graveyard, unless he's killing them, so it's not really all that reliable of a card. I think I'll probably just beat him straight up if I just